In PeopleSoft FSCM Update Image 44, PeopleSoft Inventory added two dashboards to analyze lot-controlled inventory data. These dashboards highlight important items that must either be used or disposed of because they're nearing their end of life. Let's start with the Lots Approaching Expiration dashboard. The information in this analytic tells you where you have materials that must be consumed before their expiration date. This data generates actions for the materials due to expire in 30, 60, 90, or more than 120 days. This set of analytics enables you to proactively monitor where your inventory is located and when it's due to expire. Both dashboards use the same date and filtering criteria and capabilities. The date capability allows you to change the date to suit the viewing horizon you want the charts to show. By default, the data is broken into 30-day increments and shows from 30 to more than 120 days in the charts. If you need larger or smaller increments, your dashboard administrator can change the size of the expiration days bucket. Every dashboard has a set of filters and calendar options to enable you to sort and view the data. Looking at a specific business unit enables you to see the material expiration situation in their location. You can view one or more business units for comparison purposes. The visualization shows you locations that have an abundance of inventory that's ready to expire, and where that inventory may be needed. From the drop-down list, you can select the inventory business units to include in the report. The filters allow you to narrow the view of your data by item category, item, warehouse location, and more. In this visualization, we're focusing on material in active status in inventory with a time clock based on the lot expiration date. This material has a finite shelf life, and while it sits in inventory, it becomes less viable over time. The Lots Approaching Expiration analytic looks at where these lot-controlled items reside in your organization and reports both the quantity and monetary value of the stock aging on your shelves. This first set of charts shows the monetary value of lot-controlled inventory items approaching their expiration. Let's check another chart to see how soon these lots are expiring. This visualization shows you where your material is approaching expiration, divided into time buckets. Ideally, you want to find the situation early enough to take some action to consume the materials before their expiration. Transferring some material to another location may be an option. For other material, there may be a process for disposing of expired lots. Often, disposal needs plans and documentation that require advance notice, so you can complete the process and alert the finance department of a scrap write-off for the inventory. In other words, you can proactively monitor and plan to either use it, donate it, or prepare to scrap it before the inventory expires. The Lots Approaching Expiration by Item Category shows all the item IDs within that item category. Use the Data Details tables at the bottom of the chart to see the item IDs and their lot expiration dates. Each dashboard has a detailed information grid showing the result sets of the data in the charts. The data in these grids can provide you with the information you need to deal with material approaching expiration. You can export the contents of the detailed data grid in a CSV file by clicking on the Formatted Export option in order to do your own analysis on the item and lot expiration data. You can also drill down into the details of the item balances for a particular lot to see where those lots are distributed. Clicking on the hyperlink for the business unit, item, lot combination will open a window that shows you the item balances. Now, let's move on to the non-viable item lot analysis dashboard. This dashboard is essentially a report card that tells you how your inventory teams use the information in the analytic we just discussed. The non-viable item analytic identifies expired lot-controlled items that are still in inventory, potentially causing errors due to the shipment and use of expired items. This dashboard helps you immediately sweep areas for expired materials, employ the proper disposal protocols, and make the accounting adjustments to inventory value. This dashboard provides you with the same date options and filters as the Lots Approaching Expiration dashboard. You can report on one or more business units or warehouses. The difference is that this data identifies expired material that is still showing in inventory. This material requires immediate removal from inventory. Let's look at a few of these charts. The first set of charts shows the value of expired inventory in each inventory business unit. You can scroll down to the Data Detail table to see the items, lots, and quantities in the business unit that are no longer usable but still in inventory. This grid shows you where your non-viable or expired inventory resides. You can then notify the owners of that stocking location to pull the inventory and properly dispose of it. The non-viable lot analysis by time increments shows the material that expired in the last 30 days, 60 days, or more. This chart shows inventory management effectiveness in tracking the expiration alerts from the lots approaching expiration dashboard. The item lot expiration dashboards can prevent the use of expired materials, help to avoid high-value write-offs, and allow you to direct inventory to the locations that need it before the expiration date. Leveraging the strength of our flexible and robust search indexes on your inventory data, you can create your own visualizations to monitor the materials due to expire in your facilities. For more information, go to peoplesoftinfo.com.